Hello everyone, welcome to Time Online Classes. Today in this session we will discuss very important model for IBPS PO and SBI PO prelims. Those are circular arrangement along with a variable, I mean giving some values, ages, or they are having some certain number of pens, that kind of information, where they will use generally addition, subtraction, multiplication, that kind of mathematical operations. And the one more is scheduling based puzzle. This is also very, very important. Even in scheduling based puzzles, we have lot of models. And now we are going to discuss months based question. Months based in scheduling. Okay. These two sets we are going to discuss. And these two are very, very important for IBPS PO prelims as well as for SBI PO prelims. Level of difficulty little bit may vary. In SBI PO prelims, you may get little bit higher level of difficulty. In IBPS PO prelims, you will get little bit lower level of difficulty. But ultimately, the models that you are going to get is same. Okay. Now, let's move to the set number one. Once go through the information, you will get the idea. Six persons, I through N, are sitting around a circular table facing the center, but not necessarily in the same order. Okay. We have total how many persons? Six persons. Yeah. In prelims exams, they won't give more number of persons when they give extra variables. They will give you around 6, 7, 5 like that only. Okay, not 8, 9, 10. And are sitting around a circular table and also mentioned clearly facing the center of the table. So there is no such inside and outside problem also. And each person is of a different age. So here is the extra variable. We have to place them in a circle. As well as we should also identify the ages of the each and every person. And their ages are 16, 21 and so on. The following information is known about them. Okay. Now we have given some clues. We'll copy these clues to the next slide. And there we'll discuss. Okay. Let's move to the arrangement. What will be the basic structure? I to N means I, J, K, L, M, N. And these are the ages. 16, 21, 37, 42, 50 and 58. Again. When I am appearing for the prelims exam, my approach will never change. I will start from the first clue onwards. I won't pick up any clues randomly. While going through the first clue, if it leads to the possibilities, I will write the possibilities. And whenever that, while going through the information, if that particular clue is not required at that point of time, I will keep it aside. And whenever it is required, I will use that. But I won't waste my time in reading the entire information. That is not the right approach. Okay. Especially for prelims. No. So what is my basic structure? So here it is. Six persons sitting around a circular table. What is given? K sits two places away from J. Two places away is nothing but how many gaps will be there? One gap will be there. But have they mentioned whether it is to the left side or right side? No. They didn't mention. It could be to the left side, it could be to the right side. So K is two places away from J. Who means again we are talking about J. J is the third youngest person. Already we know the ages of the persons. So third youngest is nothing but the one whose age is 37 years. So we can confirm that J's age is how many years? 37 years. So with this information, we are having two possibilities. What are those two possibilities? K may be second to the left of J or K may be second to the right of J. Okay. So, but we have to go to the second possibility or not. How we will come to know? We move to the next information. If the next information is also linked with the previous one, either with K or J, then better to draw it. Now, what is given? K sits opposite the person who is 5 years older to J. Again, these two statements are interrelated. K sits two places away from J, who is the third youngest person, and K sits opposite the person who is 5 years older to J. So these statements are interrelated so that we can understand that. So better to write the possibilities instead of writing the information side by. So what is the first one? I am taking K sits two places away from J. So J I am taking here. So case one, K sits second to the left of J. Now we have another case, right? And even we know the age of J. What is the age of J? 37 years. Age of J is 37 years. And also they given one information. K sits opposite the person. I mean this person we are talking about. K sits opposite the person who is means this person, is 5 years older to J. 5 years older to J. Now, what is the age of J? 37 years. 5 years older to J means 37 plus 5, 42 years. So, who sits opposite to K? The person whose age is 42 years. But we have a second possibility. Now, let me draw that one. In the earlier case, K is second left of J. Now, K is second to the right of J. K is second to the right of J. As usual, the age of J is 37 years and opposite to K is 5 years older than J. That is nothing but 37 plus 5, 42 years. 42 years. Same. The only difference is in this case K is second left of J and here K is second right of J. And up to here information is completed and we have two possibilities. Now what is given next? The difference between the ages of the person who sits adjacent to J is 8 years. So difference between the ages of the person who sits adjacent to J is 8 years. So J is here. Adjacent to J means immediate neighbors. So these two people, ages difference is how much? 8 years. Already one of the person age is how much? 42 years. So difference between these two people ages is 8 years and one of them is 42. Means x minus 42 modulus of x minus 42 is equal to 8 years. So this x could be higher than 42 or x could be lower than 42 because it is given in modulus. It means difference. Just it is mentioned difference, not higher or lower. So what are the possibilities? One is 50. So 50 minus 42 is 8. And what is another possibility? 34. 34 and 42 difference is also 8. But we don't have the age 34. So this case is ruled out and 50 is valid. So who sits to the immediate left of J? The person whose age is 50 years. So the same is true in this case also. The difference between the ages of the person who sits adjacent to J is 8 years. So one of them is 42. So other will be 50. Just now we discussed. So here will be the one whose age is 50 years. Next, what is given? N sits to the immediate right of I. Okay. N sits to the immediate right of I. Neither I nor N sits adjacent to J. Okay. N sits immediate right of I. And also given the neither N, I nor N adjacent to J. Means I is not adjacent to J, N is not adjacent to J. So J is here already. So I will not come in this position. Even N will not come in this position. Here also same. I will not come in this position. N will not come in this position. So J and K are already there in the arrangement. But N should be immediate right of A, I. So the only possibility is I is here. And immediate right of I is this side. So it will be N. N sits to the immediate right of I. Now let's come to this case. J is here. So neither I nor N sit adjacent to J. So here it is neither I nor N. Here also it is neither I nor N. Now already this position is occupied with J. And this position is occupied with K. Now we have to place N and I. N sits immediate right of I. So I will be here. And N is immediate right of I. It is immediate right side. N is immediate right of I. So till here completely done. Now what is given next? The sum of the ages of K plus I is equal to J. The sum of the ages of K plus I is equal to J. K plus I is equal to J. In any case, the age of J is 37 years. Now we have already given a values. So sum of which two values is equal to 37 among these given values? Simply we can say that 16 and 21. But we don't know whether K is 16 or 21 or I is 16 or 21. That we don't know. K can be 16 or 21 or I can be 16 or 21. That we don't know. Right. Let's keep it aside because we don't know confirmly. But what is given next? The age of M is twice the age of I. So what is given? The age of M is twice the age of I. Equation M equal to 2 times of I. Okay. Now earlier we have a doubt. Either I is 16 or 21. If I is 16, m will be 32. Do we have the value 32 among the given ages? No. It means I cannot be 16. So I has to be how much? 21. When I is 21, m value will be 42. Is the 42 available among the given values? Yes. So I is 21, m is 42. When I is 21, k is 16. So now we can write the age. The age of k is 16 in both the cases. In both the cases, the age of k is 16. And in both the cases, the age of I is 21. In both the cases, age of I is 21. Now, we have to write m. M. What is the age of m? 42. So here, m 42. And here the age of m 42. Now look at here. Out of the 6 persons, how many persons are fixed? K, I, N, M, J. Who is the only remaining person? L. So the age of L is 50 years. The age of L is 50 years. Now out of the 6 ages, how many ages are fixed? 5. 42, 37, 50, 16, 21. What is the remaining? 58. So the age of N is 58 years in case 2. Now let's talk about the case 1. What is the age of K? 16. What is the age of I? 21. Okay. Fine. Next. What is the age of M? 42 years. Now whom we left with? K, N, I, M, J, L. So the age of L is 50 years in both the cases. And what is the age of N? Remaining value 58. So still both the cases are valid. Now what is the last point? The difference between the ages of the person who sits adjacent to N is 5. So adjacent to N, K and I are there. Right, in this case. What is the difference between these two ages? 5 years. So it is valid. Now here we have N. In this case here we have N. Who are adjacent to N? I and M. So what are those ages? What are those persons' ages? 21 and 42. Is the difference is 5? No. It means it is violating the law statement. So this is ruled out. So this is our final arrangement. So this should be our approach in solving the set. While I am explaining, it is taking a lot of time. But when you do it on your own, when you know completely the basics and the technical terms, it is very easy to solve. Maximum it may take 2 to 3 minutes time to complete it and 1 more minute time to complete the given questions. That's fine. Okay. Now I'll give a clear picture of this diagram in the next slide. You may note it down, the final diagram. What is the age of L? What is the age of L? 50 years. Choice 4. What is the position of N with respect to the person who is 42 years old? So the 42 years old is here and N is here. So what I can say? It could be second right. It could be second right or it could be fourth left. Both are correct. Which is available in the choices? Second to the right. What is the average of the ages of K and M? What is the value of age of K? 16. What is the age of M? 42. Average means? So 16 plus 42, 8 plus 21, 29 years. Choice 5. Four of the following five are alike in a certain way and hence form a group. Find the one which does not belong to that group. N, 58 years, okay. M, 42 years. I, 21. K, 16. L, 50. Except I, remaining all the persons' ages are even numbers. whereas I, age is an odd number. Choice 3. How many persons are younger to L? How many are younger to L? What is the age of L? 50. So there is only one person who is elder to L. Means remaining all four are younger. Remaining all four are younger to L. Four more than three. Choice 5. Okay, so this is one of the important model. Sometimes instead of these values, you may be given some variable also, like countries, cities, flowers, this kind of information, subjects. But ultimately the model is same, okay? Circular with another variable. Now let's discuss another important model, scheduling based. 10 persons A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, and J were born in a different month of the same year among Jan, March, April, and so on. But not necessarily in the same order. The following information is known about them. See, all these 10 persons were born in the same year. And the months are given Jan, March, April, May, June, July, so on. So, definitely we can say one thing. First person must have born in the month of January. Second person must have born in the month of March. Third person must have born in the month of April, and so on. It means what we can freeze means, I mean, like you have to start with the arrangement. To start with the arrangement, some variable has to be taken as it is, right? Because we are distributing. We are distributing what we are distributing, which person was born in which year, which month. So when we are distributing it, one of the parameter can be taken as it is. So here you can say that first person must have born in the month of Jan, second one in the month of March, and so on. So you can freeze the months. By freezing the months, you can complete it in less time. Now, I'll copy the same information to the next slide. There we'll discuss. Again, my approach will never change. I'll go with the first clue onwards. So here is my basic structure. And one more important thing is number of days. January, 31 days. March, 31, April, 30, May, 31, June, 30, July, 31, August, 31, September, 30, October, 31 days, November, 30. At least one or two clues will be based on this, even number of days, odd number of days. That is also important for us. If it is not given, it's okay, but better to write this. What is given first clue? Only two persons were born after D was born. So after D, only two persons are there. So in which month D was born? September. So you can freeze D here. So like this, direct clues will be given. Next, what is given? Four persons were born between D and I. It could be after, it could be before, but after is not possible. So it should be before only. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and it is I. So I was born in the month of April. Now what is this given? Only one person was born between I and C. It could be before or it could be after, that we don't know. But it is given only one person was born between I and C. So if it is before, C will be in the month of January. If it is after, C will be in the month of June. So it is leading to how many cases? Two cases. So let me write the cases. C here. Now the next, second possibility, D already in the arrangement, I is already in the arrangement, now it is C, one person born between I and C. Next, the number of persons who were born after C was born is the same as the number of persons who were born before A was born. So after C is equal to before A, which is nothing but corresponding positions from the either of the ends. So first person from the beginning, so A should be last person from the beginning. Shortcut. C. Now I am talking about the C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth person from the beginning. So A will be fifth person from the end. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now if you want, cross check it. After C, 9. Before A, 9. Matching. After C, 5. Before A, 5. Matching. Next, what is given? E was born exactly between C and G. G was not born in August. G was not born in August. Both the cases are valid. G was not born in August. But what is given? E was born exactly between. Exactly between means equidistant from both the ends. C or G, G or C. Equidistant. But in both the cases, who is there already in the arrangement? C is there already in the arrangement. In both the cases, we have C. Okay. Let's check the each and every possible situation with C, E and G. Okay, C is here. If I take the E here, between C and E, 0. So E and G will be 0. No, I is already there. Okay, here already I is there. So let's come to the point E here. If it is E, between C and E, 1, 2 gaps. So E and G, 1, 2 gaps. So E, 1, 2, Z. But it is already, it cannot be G. So E cannot be here. Right. If it is E, for example, 1, 2, 3 gaps. 1, 2, 3 gaps and here will be G. It is valid. Now you cannot take E in any other position because already G came to the second from the last. And the last position is already given to A. So the only possibility is E was born in the month of June and G was born in the month of October. It is in case 1. Now let's talk about the case 2. C is already in the arrangement, right? Now we know it is whose position? A's position. And it is D's position. And it cannot be G. And it is already I position. E is exactly between C and G. Right. Now, if I take the E here, for example, here I should take the G. If it is E, C and E is 0, E and G has to be 0, but already I is there. Okay. If I take the E here, C and E is 2, but if I go to the left side to place the G, it is going out of the arrangement. So, E cannot be here. Even E cannot be here. Okay. Let's move to this side. C, it is already A. If I take the E here, between C and E, how many are there? 1. So E and G 1. So E 1 gap G. Yes, I can take G here. So it is E's position. So it is also completed. Till here we have done completely. Now what is the next information is given? B was born before. It is not mentioned immediately before. Somewhere before. B was born before J. Okay. B was born before J was born and after H was born. B was born before J was born and B was born after H was born. B was born after H was born is as good as H was born before B was born. So H was born before B was born or B was born after H was born. Okay. H was born neither in January nor in March. Okay. H is neither January nor March. Now let's look at, we have to fix H, B, J, three persons. H cannot be in these two positions. Now here how many positions are there? One and two only. But in these two positions I have to fix three, H, B, J. Because minimum to minimum, H cannot be here. Because after H, B and J has to be placed. If I take the H here, I can place only one of the B and J here. So this case is ruled out. Now only this case is valid. Now in this case it is not H. So where can I write the H, B, J? So the only possibility is H is here, B is here, J is here. So out of the 10 persons, 9 persons are fixed. Who is the only remaining person? Look at A is fixed, B is fixed, C is fixed, D is fixed, E is fixed, F. So F was born in the month of March. Here is the final arrangement. I hope it is clear. I'll give a clear picture of this diagram. Let's answer the questions. In which month was F was born? March. Choice 2. Which of the following statements is definitely false? H was born before D was born. Is the H was born before D was born? Yes, it is true. But we are looking for false statement. A was born in November. Is A was born in November? Yes, it is also true. But we are looking for false statement. F was born in a month which has odd number of days. Where is F? F is here. March month consists of 31 days. So F was born in the month which having odd number of days. Even it is also true. Only 3 persons were born after E was born. After E was born, how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is false. Choice 4. Choice 4. Okay. Next. How many persons were born between B and Z? Between B and Z, how many are there? 2 persons. Answer is 2, but choice is 1. Four of the following five are alike in a certain way and hence form a group. Odd man out question. C. C was born in a month which having 31 days. F was born in a month which having 31 days. D was born in a month which having 30 days. B. July 31 days. G. October in the month of 31 days. So except D, all were born in a month which having odd number of days. This is what I told at the beginning. So months, the number of days consists of months are very, very important. Choice 3. So please keep practicing the puzzles. And these two are the very, very important puzzles. If you have any doubts, please get back to us. That's it for today. Have a great day.